as his own love or his own will has been attested to me by manifold experience. The whole heaven is distinguished into societies according to the differences of the good of love, and every spirit who is taken up into heaven and becomes an angel is brought to the society where his love is. When he comes thither, he is as if at home and in the house where he has, as it were, been born. As the angel perceives and comes into fellowship there with those like himself, when he goes away to another place, he feels all the time a kind of resistance and the desire to return to his life, thus to his ruling love. It is in this way that fellowships in heaven are brought about, and also in hell, where they are formed according to the loves, the opposite of heavenly loves. That heaven is composed of societies and likewise hell, and that they are all distinguished according to differences of love, may be seen above, Numbers 41 to 50 and Numbers 200 to 212. That man after death is his own love may also be manifest from this, that those things are then removed and, as it were, taken away from him, which do not make one with his ruling love. If he is a good spirit, all things discordant or disagreeing are removed and, as it were, taken away, and thus he is led into his own love. It is the same with an evil spirit, but with this difference, that from him truths are taken away, and from the good falsities are taken away, until at length each becomes his own love. This is effected when the man's spirit is brought into the third state, to be described hereafter. When this is done, he turns his face constantly to his own love, and has it continually before his eyes, in whatever direction he turns. See above, Numbers 123 and 124. All spirits may be led at pleasure, provided only they be kept in their ruling love, nor can they resist. However aware they may be of what is being done, they think that they will resist. At times, the trial has been made whether they can do anything contrary to the ruling love, but they tried in vain. Their love is as a bond or rope with which they are, as it were, tied round, by which they may be drawn and from which they cannot loosen themselves. The case is similar with men in the world, whom their own love also leads, and through their love they are led by others, but more so when they become spirits, because then it is not allowed to present to appearance any other love and to counterfeit what is not their own. That the spirit of man is his ruling love is made manifest in all interactions in the other life. For so far as any one acts and speaks in agreement with the love of another, so far the latter is fully seen with a full, cheerful, lively countenance. But as far as any one acts and speaks contrary to another's love, so far the other's countenance begins to be changed, to be darkened, and not to be seen, till at length he wholly disappears, as if he had not been there. I have often wondered that this should be so, because nothing of the kind can take place in the world. But I have been told that it is the same with the spirit in man, which, when it turns itself away from another, is no longer in his view. That a spirit is his ruling love was also made evident by this, that every spirit seizes and appropriates to himself all things agreeable to his love, and rejects and removes from himself all things that are not agreeable. Everyone's love is like spongy and porous wood, which imbibes such fluids as conduce to its vegetation and repels others. And it is like animals of every kind, which know their proper food and seek what agrees with their nature, and avoid what disagrees. For every love wishes to be nourished by its own, evil love by falsities, and good loves by truths. It has sometimes been given me to see that certain simple good spirits wished to instruct the evil in truths and goods, but that these, at the instruction, fled away, and when they came to their own, seized with much pleasure the falsities which were in agreement with their love. I have also seen good spirits conversing together about truths, and this conversation the good who were present heard. experience in the spiritual world are real appearances which correspond to truths or falsities, and therefore ways in the divine word signify truths or falsities. By this